Sorry. It's a full studio. I've got Oris. I've got James Silas.
Yeah!
And I've got Afro Labby Mr. Schofield.
Oh, thank you. That sounds sweet.
Yes. All right, so welcome to the Grapevine. We're already streaming live up on youtube.com. /smooth981fm Lagos. You can also leave your chats up there because, oh boy, we're going to be talking about criticisms and how the critics of Election Oba are doing. So, how YouTube, come join the live chat. You can also join the chat up on WhatsApp. The number for that is 0809-444-0981. And you can tweet at us, hashtag Grapevine981. I got it all. Hi, James's audience. How are you?
And live on Instagram as well, James Silas.
Instagram, James Silas. All right, people. So you have a wealth of ways to reach us and a wealth of ways to leave your comments and join the show. So do it. All right, so let's get into the music. Ah, Wakanda. Your footprints are everywhere. Last time I was here, we talked about Rihanna. And this time now, we're going to talk Burna. And I love how Burna and Rihanna are starting to have a lot more points of connection. Mm. Apart from Marvel, we've got Fenty. That's all for now. I can't think of any more.
unless you want to say Beyonce and Rihanna have that rivalry too going on, and there was Burna Boy on both of them. So I don't know, something like that.
Degrees of connection, they're coming. They're coming. All right, so let's get straight into this. So what we're going to start off with for our music review today is Alone. This is Burna Boy for Marvel, Black Panther, Wakanda Forever. Let's get a snippet of it and then we'll be back to talk. And the speakers go up for you guys.
Another fight for my life is alright, because everything dies, nobody know why. What can I go do? What can you go do when you're feeling like you're falling? I can't find nothing to hold on to.
All right, people, it had to be just a snippet because Grapevine is only half an hour long. But let's get straight into it. So who wants to go first, y'all?
Me.
Okay, Oris, you get to go first.
Yes. I think this is a superb song. Although, of course, you say you expect it from Burna, right? But I've always felt like Burna has maybe more than two modes. I think he has this more club-friendly songs that Nigerians are usually giddy about, you know? But he also has this sober... Do you remember this song? It's Primi from his EP, Redemption. That's so Fasol, there's a Fasol Latido song. Anyway, this is what I'm trying to make here, actually. You know, he has this EP released shortly after his second album on a spaceship called Redemption. And that particular record has, I don't know, four or five songs. Two of them are quite sober and excellent. But if you asked even the staunchest Burna Boy fans from Nigeria, very few of them would know they wouldn't actually recognize these songs. So I think, yeah, there's this Burna mode that's sober that not a lot of us are like super familiar with, but there are times where I feel like that is the better Burna, actually. On occasion, yeah, so this song belongs to that mode. Maybe, of course, this is because it's a Marvel production.
Yeah,
but yeah, I just think it's such a good song, and of course you probably would not hear this in the club unless somebody does remix to this song.
But
I think that
you will not,
for just like streaming in your home, it's such a great
because I felt like this was a very introspective Burna, and listening to it, I started thinking about the meaning of life. I'm not sure.
That might be his intention, actually. That might be his intention.
This is kind of what, when I'm okay with the rest of my life, guys, I don't want to be sad about life. And I'm
so I guess this is like, the reason.
What does it all mean?
This is why Nigerians don't know these songs I'm talking about, because they are too sober for our
situation. Man, we're struggling.
But they're great songs, but they're such great songs.
No, but this is a great song. Such a great song. I'm not even going to.
I was telling James earlier that I'm looking forward to a live performance of this thing. Oof.
Oh,
with
yeah.
the right atmosphere. I'm telling you, man. It might be close to spiritual.
And I was saying to him that picture everybody all lights out, everybody put your phone up, if there are candles, put your candles up.
Right.
I mean, this song is
they did that for Yemi Alade in Paris.
This song is basically they do it for everybody.
Don't do this.
So, but this song is a song that, clearly from the Wakanda Marvel album, and this is one of the songs dedicated to. Chadwick, but you know,
Boswick.
And
you know the joke? You get
Boswick,
the joke?
Oh my gosh,
stop it. So, but I mean, it's like you said, it's a very, very
sober song.
It's a sad song, and it's basically what the song does is what it is just more or less touching that whole life of Bosman from. You know, with the cancer, the sickness, the illness, the pain, the trauma, everything that the guy went through. That's what he basically put into this particular record. The emotion, you can feel the soul from this record. And so the fun thing is that when I got the playlist for this project, and I was looking through, I mean, everybody, we've all heard the Rihanna one. And I was looking at the playlist and I just said, okay, where was Burna Boy? Because there were no names on it. So I just said, okay, alone. Let me listen to this alone. And boom, it was
there were no names on it.
No, like so the track, I got the tracks, but there were no, you know, like no credit to the person or the artist.
When I saw her,
that's what I saw. You know. So and then I just said, okay, where will Burna Boy be on this project? And I just clicked on it, boom, and that was Burna Boy. And as far as I'm concerned, is the best or the most powerful song on the project.
It's just the Burna Boy being the normal Burna Boy.
No,
it's not the first time you will hear Burna, you know, sing a song of this magnitude. Go back to his album when he sang 23. You know, that's the kind of song you want to listen to in the morning. To, you know, put your mood up, and you know that you said, okay, yes,
you got Oris thinking
exactly.
Yeah, I want to say that 23 is not this song.
Context 20, different.
Actually, 23 is a very self-aggrandizing song.
Yes,
he's talking about him being like Jordan.
Yes,
it's not on the same level, actually.
Yeah. Okay, to you, it might not be on the same level, but when
let's just go through the lyrics.
Lyrically, it's definitely different because this one is a sad song. Do you understand? But where I'm going to on this one is Burna Boy has shown that he can conquer any genre of music. So when I listened to this morning, I was like, this is a different Burna. And I think I would like to hear this type of Burna more of it.
And by the way, can I just say, I think, so either Burna's star is just outclipsing all my algorithms or every, I don't know, because maybe he's been speaking about him quite a bit recently.
I see him everywhere. Your phone can hear you.
Like, he's on Burberry with Shakira, he's doing this with this, he's on Savage X Fenty, he's on this. I'm just like, Burna, my eyes are shut and now I'm seeing you everywhere. What's going on?
It's Burna season, man.
Yeah, it's Burna season.
Burna 10, I guess, kind of. Burna 10 season.
Yeah, it's both their seasons.
Burna is like father, I believe, yeah. Anyway,
All right, we'll move on. Oh, but speaking of, and I love that we've been talking about, you know, the kind of character of this song of Alone, and it really does fit because the reviews are in for Wakanda Forever, Black Panther 2, and obviously we had premieres.
50 premieres in Nigeria. I thought it's one Black premiere, but like 50 premieres in Nigeria. There was two yesterday. Just yesterday, two. I'm like, how? Yes. Lagos is doing 3 million.
One of the cinema has had about 1,000 people. Came. In fact, when my friend got to the cinema, they had to tell him, no, you can't go in because it's filled up. There's no space.
What did you expect, though? What were we gonna expect?
I don't know. No, for me, just like premier. How many premier? Okay, no,
yes, yes. But premiers were invited. So how did they? How did they? I mean, they are supposed
people
to
be their friends and family, and not just, you know, one ticket, three people.
So, you have not been to a Nigerian party, wedding, anything before?
I don't know why. I think they abused this one.
Yeah, yeah, no,
the
no, you are right.
They were private. They were very, you know, very niche. I don't know how they. I mean, it's summer.
Okay. Anyway, so yeah, and the reviews are in, and people are like, yeah, this is a film that is grappling with
grief. Well, okay, I have to see it first, because the first installment I didn't think was great, and I saw the review saying, hey, great as well, not true at all. So I'm hoping this is a better one than the first one. Well, and I'm not believing the reviews.
There's
so
another
far.
Film that you didn't think was that great, and apparently, I'll let you know that.
let's go to that later.
But we'll talk about that after the break, people. So you just keep sending your messages in on WhatsApp to 0809. How many languages do I have to say this in? No. But let's talk Rihanna now, because Rihanna has talked about what she's going to be bringing to Super Bowl. Only is extremely vague. We just know it's going to be awesomeness, because that's the only thing that can get her away from her child at the moment. So I saw an interview she had on with Entertainment Tonight, and Rachel Smith, I think it was. And so she talked about her decision to do the 2023 Super Bowl halftime show. I said that it was a surprise, but it was the only thing that would have prompted her as a new mother to leave her baby, saying, I can't believe I even said yes. Oris, why are you doing your eyes like that? Oris, make me take this story. And now he's pulling faces at it. I don't think so.
I'm just saying that, you know, motherhood is not something I'm familiar with. So, what can I say?
You will get.
But I'm very familiar with
you. You're a human being. Put yourself in the shoes of another human being.
Haven't you heard that question people ask, that which is more painful, childbirth or getting kicked in the balls?
Childbirth.
See, said a woman, right? You know, and you actually, the conclusion is this. One person can never have an answer, because one person can't experience both.
Oh, yeah. You don't know that we're living in 2022 and people have...
Please, let's not get into that, please. Identity politics, not today.
Okay. No,
not today.
A man gave birth to a child, so I don't understand.
No, but this is not the topic. You guys should...
It's like, I'm like, I don't want to go into this.
I'm just letting you know that one person can.
Don't worry.
So, thank you, James.
The Super Bowl is like the Grammy of performances, should we say. Everybody, all artists, I mean, you start checking the what stages, you start counting the awards you've won, you want to, you know, what's the climax of a lot of this.
Yeah,
as probably like one of the, you know, it's we have how many thousands of artists everywhere. If you are picked to perform at the Super Bowl, that's
a big deal,
you know, we can count with our fingers how many artists have actually done the Super Bowl. Mm-hmm. You know, so I think the context of what Rihanna, what she was saying there, is like, what, Super Bowl? Why not? That's a good reason to, you know, hey, baby, stay with the nanny, just stay backstage.
Get up and go.
Let me do this. And, you know, so I think that's basically what it is. Well, hey, who? Why not?
No, of course not.
You know, no.
Who says no to Super Bowl?
I just wish she sings that kiss me better.
But I love that. But what it is, I don't think we're going to get new music from her. So this thing, Erba was on the show on Tuesday. And he was like, yeah, this means that we're going to, well, no, not this Tuesday, last Tuesday. I was like, this means that we're going to get new music from her. But
no, I think she actually said that that's not what this means.
Yeah, that's what she said. So yeah. I think somewhere in my heart, like a little piece of glass just broke. Because I've been one of those who was waiting for new music from Rihanna. And I don't can't lift me up. As the new music I was waiting for.
Yeah, that's why. Because I think it's an important song, but I don't think it's a great song. But that's
yeah. Yeah, thank you. Oris, you said, I find that, I don't know why, recently I'm starting to agree more and more with Oris.
Like, he was always correct. Oris was always right. That's the thing, right? People come to revelation later than others.
That's not it.
Surprise, right?
Every morning, Oris walks in. Every morning, Oris walks in and idolizes and just throws a lot of compliments at Sope, and Sope is beginning to get to your head.
No.
Oh, James, I like you. You're a very good storyteller.
That's what it
is. Because that's
which means he's a very good liar, right?
No, that's not a lie.
That's a giant
lie. Then he walked in and like, oh, you cut your hair. Oh, I'm not happy about it. And look at you, your hair's growing real fast.
Oh my God.
Boris is worth fertilizer.
We're going on a break. We'll be back. And when we get back, we're going to be talking about that film that everybody's talking about, and the film that the people have talked about, the people that were talking about the film. We'll be back with Ella Sheena back. Keep it tuned. It's the Grapevine on Smooth Breakfast.
You want to cause civil war in this country? This Elisheba job that you are taking. No, just come and close down.
Just know that Muabu is listening.
I watched that film and I was like, free our
imagination. What's going on? That was like 30 minutes, right?
Although it should have been shorter, to be honest. Whatever you think, it should have been shorter than that. Whatever you think it was, it should have been shorter than that.
I'm slowly but surely getting back into movies and TV, right?
Or did you take
I left it. I was on K-dramas only.
Ah!
At C-dramas.
These people.
Hey! We are growing in numbers, but I left them and I come back to the fold.
Thank you.
I started watching all the movies that I missed, and then I was going to watch Black Adam yesterday. And I came out with the track. It's bad.
I don't expect anything.
Oh, it's bad. There's a point where the film comes to what seems like a natural close. You don't want to see any more of Dr. Fate's visions or whatever. You're just like, it's come to an end. This is the end of the film. It's the end. Let's go. Then there's more. That's all you
wait,
need to know.
There's more.
There is more. You're like, credits. No, they refuse to play the credits and they keep playing more film.
Oh. Huh. Well, doing just
that. Tega slept. And then there was a point.
That was where you went to yesterday.
Oh, God, it was horrific. Then we now came out and I stayed in 3 hours of traffic for an 8 minute drive.
Wow.
And at the end of it, when I staggered into my house, I was like, oh, I went through all that traffic for Black Adam.
Oops. Such a shame.
Oops. It was not great.
What? 3 hours where? Mainland or Ireland?
There was mad traffic yesterday, so apparently there was National Arts
APC Convention.
National Arts Festival.
Yeah. Okay. And it was horrific.
People were stuck on the road and stuff.
Because I'd seen, like, at midday, the traffic was getting up there, but I was like, oh, is it just lunch traffic? It's bad lunch traffic. But then when we now left the cinema, we were like, oh, what just happened? It was terrible. Ah, that film. They should pay me to watch it. You know, I have not gotten up and left a cinema since I watched Godzilla in the cinema.
Oh,
versus
King Kong, the last one? Or which one?
I can't remember. This was years ago.
Years ago.
No, it was Godzilla. Just Godzilla. And there was a point at which I was like, come on, let's get going. The film is over. It's over. I don't care. It's over. You might still be playing on the screen, but it's over in my mind. Let's go. No. We stayed there, torturing ourselves.
So what is interesting to me, I find it very difficult to leave a film in the middle.
I find it super difficult. I have slight OCD tendencies. I will watch anything and read anything. I'll be there saying, this is so bad, I'll leave. But I'm still reading this one. I said, I had finished all of it, it's so bad. I had finished rolling my eyes and seeing my brain. I was like, I just want to go home. You know that song that I was singing it in my mind. And then out loud at a point.
I'll be back.
Sorry, people, there were some important conversations taking place off air with regards to a certain film, DC film, called Black Adam. Okay, now let's talk about what we need. No, let's not. First of all, let's talk about Hushpuppi. Because it's a Grapevine, we gotta do this. So, first, Hushpuppi is supposed to spend 11 years in jail and pay $1.7 million to two fraud victims. Go ahead, people, what do you think?
I think the most important part of that story is the adaptation that's supposed to come out.
Thank you. That is the most important part for me. James, would you say that?
Oh, yeah,
okay,
course.
Let's talk
if there'll be, I mean, but 50 Cent. I don't know how much of the story or how much, you know, of the plot that 50 Cent will know. Maybe they will have someone else to
put it. It's just the businessman.
You know, so and I don't know, sometimes 50 Cent, I don't know whether to take him seriously when he says this thing. But we know, I think there was one time, was it, we're talking about it downstairs, I don't know if it was
Yes. There was the announcement earlier this year or later, I can't remember about Will Parker, the producer.
Yes.
And Mo doing, working on the same
story.
And they said they had actually bought the Bloomberg, there was a long
piece
in Bloomberg about this topic and they had bought the rights. So I'm just like, what is 50's own there?
So we don't know. We don't know, maybe it's connected, are they going to contract him to come and direct it or whatever, but let's even, fingers crossed. But it also reminds us of someone like
what's his name, the Naco people, what's his name? El Chapo, you know, yeah. Those stories are usually public like this. Mm-hmm. I mean, Hushpuppi is also, it was a big story on CNN as well. It was just global.
Big story everywhere. Yeah.
You know, somehow, some way, I just feel like the media also finds a way to, you know, glamorize.
To be unfortunate. Fair, true, that's true.
You know?
To be fair, I have to say, Nigeria does have a long and storied past when it comes to folk films. So yeah, it would be nice to see it kind of up on the screen, mm-hmm, along with the rest. Sure, we mm-hmm also have some amazing things. Also, would be nice to see up on the screen and our culture.
But you'll take Hushpuppi.
I'll take Hushpuppi. All right. Yeah.
So I mean, let's see how that plays out. You know, but I don't know. Does the guy have 1 point? I was saying, does he still have that much? That's what they're asking him for. And some people are saying, oh, it's possible that he still has money stashed somewhere. That, you know. But let's
see.
Is he
a Nigerian?
So, but he has spent 2 years
that came
already
into large amounts of cash.
Well,
he'd rather have some of that money locked up somewhere that nobody else can get it.
We don't know. He has to. He has spent 2 years already.
I think he has to. Have. Yeah, he spent. I think they have to know he actually has that money.
Uh huh. So
for every first time, they usually have backup. So
exactly.
Thank
you.
So they know.
So for people that he didn't call
back. I am not a fraudster, but I know I would have backup.
But people that he didn't rat out?
Maybe. No. I'm saying he himself. Of course, they probably have access to all of his accounts now. So they know the guy has that money. I'm sure he does.
So did he freeze everything?
They wouldn't have been able to.
Mm-hmm. And he will have properties not, you know, directly linked to his
name. He has like 3 million phones or something. I'm sure he's selling each of those phones. That money.
Meanwhile, we'll be getting messages that I didn't see. So let's go into WhatsApp. Taya says, is Hushpuppi entitled to proceeds from this proposed adaptation?
No. Sorry, that's not how it works. It's the person who wrote the story that gets
great. It's like 50 Cent about to beat Team Mo. He also says, Burna Boy knows how to tap into his emotions. Always hoping this mood comes out more often, but this is not Burna on a normal day.
Exactly what I said.
And
that's not what you said, but okay. That's exactly what you said. Opposite of that.
And okay. Kaya continues saying, congrats to us on Wakanda premiere in Lagos. No breathing space for our guests, but I don't know what I find more embarrassing. Oh. That Letitia was asked by a certain national reporter what her name was. Yes.
Yes, yes. We all saw that.
Or getting Chadwick Boseman's name wrong.
Chadwick Boseman.
Inch me for body. And he also says, thank God Tenok, Namor, didn't use 5 calories worth to wash the event away in anger, says Tyler. And Cruz says, what's the meaning of Chabai? Oh, I don't know.
Chabai is just to enjoy. So.
Just to enjoy. Yes.
Be high.
Oh.
Get into thank that
you
mood.
Yeah.
Thank you. And he also says, Chabai Oris is actually on the path of a little bit of repentance. That's why. Oh, that's why I'm starting to agree more.
Who are these people? Who are these people?
I don't believe it.
It is not true at all. Actually.
I don't believe it. Look, he's even come out and repeated this statement.
I am always honest.
In its entire.
From the beginning of time. That's true, actually. Always.
Always. But you know what they say about honest people?
What did you say about?
Oh, what did you say about? Oh, yes. We're getting there.
Was very economical.
Yeah, God.
He was tactful.
Yeah.
And Tizikolo, who says, what is the title of Burna Boy's song? It is Alone.
Alone, yeah.
Yes.
And please listen to it. It's excellent.
And it's on Marvel's, what's it called? Album for Wakanda.
Mm. And it's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. I can say that. Yeah. My full chest. Yes. And Elkomo says, Travaille means to work.
Mm-hmm. No, it doesn't.
Is that what it means? No. I'm pretty sure that's not it.
That's not what it does at all.
It's what I said. Hi.
In events like this, happy.
Mm-hmm.
Funny.
Mm-hmm. Happy.
We're very, very happy. Yes,
but
yes.
Back in the day, there was this song, Jogodo, not the.
And that's it, that's Travaille too. That's Travaille too.
Exactly, Professor Lincoln. But they interviewed him. I know he was saying something about it being spiritual. And I'm like, who are you trying to deceive? This guy.
All right, should we move on? Yeah, all right. Let's get to this. Now, where should I find this? Let's make this an item of news on the Grapevine before we end this show. We have 5 minutes, gentlemen. So, let me read the headline for you guys. You listening? Mo Abudu takes a swipe at critics of Alessia Oba, calls them uneducated. The brain behind the reins of Ebony Live Studios, Mo Abudu, responding to the negative criticism trailing her Alessia. I love how this thing puts it as her Alessia Oba, the King's Horseman, as directed by the late B. Bandele, who was an absolutely fantastic creative mind, and may his soul rest in peace.
Yes,
yeah.
But sure. Also, Alessia Oba was not what I would have. Everything I would
read most comments important to get the context.
Yeah, okay, I'll do that. Give me 1 second while I pull it up for you. I love the reports. Where are you seeing it? Why are you pointing? Point.
Go ahead, Sophie. This song is actually big.
Like I was saying, thank you. I'm about to read this for you.
I'm just shocked.
Yeah, you're shocked, right? So let's start talking about it while I pull it up.
You see, one of my problems with directors and producers within the larger movie industry is the ability to take criticism.
Their inability to take criticism.
Their inability and the ability not to take criticism. See, I feel what makes you a better person is when someone criticizes your work, you take a second eye and look at whatever it is you've done. Okay, what can I do to make this better? Mm. But why would you call people uneducated?
So what I'm going to read is her point now. So she said that the King's Horseman will stand the test of time forever and ever. It will always be a reference point in moving pictures, as it's the first time that this play has been done as a feature film. It will go over the heads of some because they are uneducated about this work. In quotation marks, please. Oh, so, you know, that lessens the sting. But I'm glad to see that many of your followers, she's talking to Demi at this point, are exposed to understanding the concepts and thematics displayed in our film. It truly is a work of art.
Okay, let me play the devil's advocate
for a second. And as with art, by the way, there are going to be detractors and there are going to be those who are fully behind it. It's art, man. It's supposed to make you feel things.
Let me play the devil's advocate for a minute. So maybe I want to just assume that uneducated in this context is uninformed, like if you've not seen or if you don't know anything about it.
She said uneducated about this work, so yes.
So maybe that's what exactly she's talking about. So maybe if you've not seen before and then you just feel like, you know. So, but now bringing it back to criticism as it is, which is what Oris is here for, you know, what we are somehow
not here for, but yes,
but I feel like she didn't take it in a good way at all. Let me tell you, she's done a couple of works. What's it called? Chief Daddy, the original, the first version. Everybody, we all liked it, you know. But then
some people liked it.
Mm. And then she now came with the second one, which didn't go down well. You know, people didn't.
Everybody seemed to hate that one.
And she had actually done a couple of works that, you know, we applauded. I mean, we have to say, when it comes to Olosho, it was fantastic, you know. And when it comes to even with the whole the scenery, the film, the art itself, you know, from not just directing, picture quality,
yes, the production
and
value.
All of this production quality. Thank you. You know, she's. I mean, you have to give her. She's one of those excellent who has actually put their sticks
fantastic
up, their neck out
cinematography,
to make
fantastic sound.
Exactly. Yes,
there's a clear sound. There's a clear body like sound.
You cannot take away the fact that when people watch, we've seen your works, we've seen, you know, things you've done in the past, and then we feel like this one does not cut it, and then you now want to be upset or want to start, you know, fighting everybody on social media and, you know, jabbing at everybody.
Well, she didn't fight everybody.
Hey, that's what it is. Because I'm concerned, she put all comments, the negative, I think it was, you know,
the positive ones,
you know, trying to just shed light on, look at what people are saying. But if you look at it, there are a lot of people like Oris that were actually invited and, you know, giving special treatment to come and watch it and not say anything bad about it. But look, it's not going to fly.
James, okay.
That movie,
can I speak?
No, you're not going to say anything yet.
Okay, please.
The movie, see, I saw the stage play, I've read the book. And then I watched this movie and I was like, wait, what's going on? And I was telling Oris downstairs that I think the only part, apart from, you know, if you've read the book, which is the education part that she's probably talking about, you already know the story. I've seen it on stage. And when it was enacted on stage, what I told Oris was that I didn't know that, or the stage did not portray that it was the son committed suicide, you know, on stage. There was a dead body. There was a body was brought to the stage, and you know, all of the conversation and everything on stage. It just didn't depict to me that it was the son that committed suicide that they brought, you know, when he was in prison. But in the movie, it was really clear because they actually now showed the son's face and even when they were lying side by side, you know. So that one I thought, okay, yeah, but a lot of parts,
the strange stage production,
some parts were overflogged. I mean, I liked Brimo's. What's it called?
Liked Brimo's character.
Yes, his character. I liked the fact that Brimo could, and I really, really loved it. That Brimo was, you know, was a good thing for him.
For me, Brimo was a fantastic standout.
Absolutely.
In that film.
Yes,
yeah,
he was. So, but generally, the movie just didn't cut it. I shout out to Bamdele, when it comes to the directing, the, you know, interpreting what the movie was about or the story was about, he did well. but a lot of things were flogged. And then who says we couldn't have added more flesh, more context, or more, you know? But like you said always last week, that the guy paid, or they paid more homage or more attention to the work of showing that, not wanting to touch or, you know, dent it or expand it or, you know, reenact outside the context or outside the
but
story.
Sometimes I think what happens also is like when a creator is around to see their work and you're paying homage to that creator, sometimes it's different when somebody has left you their work for you to be able to kind of get your sink your teeth into.
But
there's a difference.
Especially
in Nigeria and our culture.
I just want to say that anyway, that this film, the major flaw is, the strength is actually its flaw, which is paying too much respect to Soyinka's work. I think if you are a director, if you're a film director, one of the things you need to do when you're adapting something is to offer an educated disrespect of the text, you know. And I think that's the primary failure of Elesin Yoruba. It's too respectful to Soyinka. So it helps it in a way that the normal Nollywood cliche dialogue is not there, because those are Soyinka's words. Soyinka's words are still fresh even now. But the problem with that is that it now just looks like an expensive stage production with cameras, you know. And I think that's the thing that I could just not let go. Everybody seems to, it just felt to me like somebody was off stage shouting, project, 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 like they're listening on stage performances. And man, I can't let that just go, you know.
With two people were speaking completely different languages, conk even, and they're understanding each other. Thank you very much and goodbye. We've come to the end of the show, but not the end of the show, because the James and Silas, the James and Oris show, comes up.
You catch it on YouTube as well.
Exactly. Yes,
guys.
Yes,
today, this evening, actually, you get to catch it this evening.
Yeah.
We already have two episodes.
Yes, two episodes. So, I mean, guys, James and Oris, nobody tells us to shut up on the
exactly.
Oris show.
Shokwe is not bullying us there, so we're just talking and talking.
Meanwhile,
and talking.
You can catch me on Instagram, Facebook. Clubhouse, everywhere, Twitter, you can catch me as James Silas. I'm there, just holler at me. If you tell me you're from the Grapevine, trust me.
Look at looking
inside.
Holler back. Yes, and it's
take your mind,
catch, it's Catch Oris on Twitter and Catch Oris Gram on Instagram. I will be out for 2 weeks, so try not to miss me, guys.
Yeah! I
took the mic.
No, but we're not done. Can we know where we're going to find them?
Follow me, exactly.
Where are you going to find me?
Yeah. Right, somewhere
in the studio, but basically majorly on Twitter. So it's just I am a Falabi with double I.
Okay, and real quick, let me just read this message from Lola, who says Elesin Yoruba was badly done. There was a disconnect translating a play to a screenplay. They could have done better. Great graphics and coloring does not make a movie. The market / village outfits, etc., those scenes looked so new and unused. Ebony Life has started believing their own hype. They need a lot of strategic direction in the days going forward, not to lose credibility, says Lola. Ooh, Lola, you said
that's
a lot.
That's good.
Thank you for adding your voice to the Grapevine conversation. No, James. No, we got to go.
What happened?
You guys say I'm a bully, but I'm giving you way more
time
than you
need. Let's take it to YouTube.
Yeah, take it to YouTube. Just keep it tuned up on youtube.com/smooth981fm Lagos.
So that guy came back.
What did the guy say?
He said that the word travailler is a French.